Now, we are dealing with the order Lepidoptera, and it contains the families Noctuidae, Sphingidae, Pyralidae, Galechidae, Arctidae. These are the representative ones which are related with our agricultural practices, being the pests or acting in some or the other way. So, order Lepidoptera, the synonym for this order, Glossata. Lepido means scale and tera means wings. So the union of this word makes it Lepidoptera. Rather, the common names in these are the moths, the butterflies, the characteristics of this order, the body, wings, appendages, they are densely clothed with overlapping scales. We know the types of wings, the scaly wings, which give the rigidity as well as color to the wings, and it does have strength for good flights. The wings insulate the body and smoothen the airflow over the body. Then the mouth parts in adults are of siphoning type. These are the haustellate type of mouth parts. The mandibles are absent because they are feeding on the liquid, the nectar only. The galley of maxillae, in the mouth parts there are galley which are present in the maxillary area, or they are the extensions in the maxillae, are greatly elongated and they held together by interlocking hooks and spines, and it forms a proboscis that is coiled up like a spring or watch spring. That you know that in earlier times there used to be watches which had springs, and those springs used to provide the energy for the movement or the functioning of the clock. And this proboscis is kept beneath the head when not in use. It is kept coiled. Then the wings are membranous and covered with overlapping pigmented scales. Forewings are larger than the hind wings, and the cross wings are few in number. Wings are coupled by either frenet or amplexiform type of wing coupling apparatus. What is frenet type? Here you can see, or you may be knowing that there is a frenulum and retinaculum in the wing. This frenulum is just like hair, or just like a spine, which get itself attached or packed in the retinaculum or the catch just in the forewing. So they are having frenet or amplexiform type of wing coupling apparatus. The larvae are polypod. Polypod means they have more than three legs or three pairs of legs other than the I told you not to have such comments. Okay, don't put the chat comments, leave it off. Okay, the larvae are erusiform type, means they are having more cylindrical shape. Then adults are adapted for chewing with strong mandibles. A group of lateral ocelli is found on other side of the head, lateral ocelli on either side of the head, both sides. Then the antennae is short and three segmented. Antennae is three segmented. There are three pairs of five segmented thoracic legs ending in claws. Yes, there are three pairs of five segmented thoracic legs. Segments are five in the thorax, and they are having claws. 2 to 5 pairs of fleshy unsegmented prolegs. This we have seen in the abdominal appendages. The prolegs are found in abdomen at the bottom of the proleg. Crockets are present, and these crockets, they are attaching themselves, or they can hold very strongly the surface or the substratum where they are feeding leaves or any other place. Then the pupa is generally optic type of pupa. What does this mean? It is adictus type of pupa, where whole of the body is kept intact inside the pupa. Okay, it is not like the decticus exarate pupa. Then it is either naked or enclosed in a cocoon made out of soil grass, silk or larval hairs. This cocoon is prepared from soil grass. Grass is the material which is dead one, or which is the excreta just produced after feeding on the plants, and that grass gets entangled to the pupa and it prepares a cocoon. Silk, all of this, and the larval hair. Then the classification. Majority of the Lepidopteran insects, 97%, is under the suborder Dytrycia. So here are two suborders, the Dytrycia and Monotrycia. 97% of these insects, they are in the order, suborder Dytrycia, and where the female in this Dytrycia has two pores, one pore for copulation and another for the egg release. The copulatory pore is located in the 8th abdominal sternite, 8th abdominal sternite, and egg pore is on the 9th abdominal sternite. The remaining insects are grouped under the suborder Monotrycia, in which the female insects have no pores, only one pore, sorry, it does have one pore. Then the butterfly families and moth families, these are the two types or two classifications under this order Lepidoptera, wherein the names, I'll say it first, the names of the families of butterfly group: the Nymphalidae, then Lycaenidae, then third Papilionidae, Satyridae. Okay, these are the five families we can, or we just generally deal with for our studies regarding agriculture. So Satyridae, Pieridae, Papilionidae, Lycaenidae, and Nymphalidae. Okay, got it. So what happens in this? First of all, the Nymphalidae, they are brush footed or four footed butterflies, means one pair of legs may not be that much active, and not again, okay, avoid it. The four legs are short, they are functionless, hairy, and folded on the thorax. What? The four legs are short. In case of Nymphalidae, they are functionless, hairy, and folded on the thorax, means they are not utilized. Then the fore tibia is short and covered with long hair. Fore tibia is short and covered with long hair. Larvae is with many processes or spines on the body. Larvae is with many processes or spines on the body. There are spines on the body, means the hair on the body. Then the example, castor butterfly, Argolis merioni. It is a defoliator, means the larvae are only feeding. And to tell about this order, almost all adults from this order Lepidoptera, almost all, I mean to say that these members, the larval stage is only damaging stage. You keep this in mind whenever you are studying regarding the crop pest, store grain pest. So the damaging stage is the larval stage, which is active feeding stage on our economic produce. Got this? And in case of adults, only the moth, that is fruit sucking moth, it is causing damage to the fruits. Next is Lichenidae. These members in the Lichenidae, they are called as the blues or coppers or hair streaks. So the compound eyes are white rimmed. There is a white ring around their compound eyes. Then the antennae are with white rings. Then the upper wing surface is either metallic blue or coppery. Lower wings, the lower wing surface is lighter in color. The hind wing is often with delicate hair like prolongations and two or three black spots. Larvae are flattened with retractile head. Larvae are flattened with retractile head means they can put their head back. Okay, it can extend or get its head position at the backside, means it can retract it. Example is pomegranate fruit borer. This is also called as anar caterpillar, Varroa isocrates. The next is Papilionidae. They are the most, you may say, the beautiful ones, the swallowtails. They are often large and brightly colored. Their colors are bright. The prothoracic legs have tibial epiphyses. Then, in many species, hind wings has tail-like prolongation. There is tail-like prolongation. Amplexiform type of wing coupling is present. The larval body is either smooth or with tubercles. Tubercles are the extensions outside on the body of these larvae. Maybe there are some hair on it. Then osmeteria may be present in the in some larvae. These osmeteria, I have told regarding the dominance of insects, and when for dominance they will have this osmeteria used for driving away their natural enemies, and it does release some volatiles which keeps the natural enemies away. For example, the citrus butterfly, Papilio demoleus. This butterfly you might have seen in your orchards of citrus. The next is Pieridae. These are called as the whites or sulfurs. Pieridae, they are white or yellow or orange colored with black markings. The larvae is green, elongate, and covered with fine hair. It is fine hair. Then the larval body segments have annulets. Example, Dencha caterpillar and Eurema hecabe is the scientific name of this Dencha caterpillar. Fifth is Satyridae. The browns, meadows, or the meadow browns. They are dull brown and maybe blackish in color. The wings are with eye-like spots both on the upper and lower surface. Example, rice horned caterpillar, Melanitis ismin. So these were the members of the butterfly families. Now the Arctidae, the tiger moths from the moth families. One by one we'll just have a look at them. The wings are conspicuously spotted or banded. They are nocturnal. Butterflies are having their appearance in the daytime. They are diurnal. Butterflies are diurnal. These moths are nocturnal. They are attracted to the light. The larvae is either sparsely hairy or densely hairy. The woolly bear is an example, or it may look like a woolly bear. Then black hairy caterpillars, Estigmin lactinia is the scientific name of this one. Stop those. The next family is the silkworm moth family. Silkworms, the family is Bombycidae. Okay, and this Bombycidae, it is generally the mulberry silkworm. The antenna is bipectinate. Then the larvae is either with a tuft of hairs on or glabrous with medio dorsal horn on the 8th abdominal segment. So abdominal segment, 8th abdominal segment, and on that 8th abdominal segment it is going to have a horn like structure, means a projection, and that projection is sensory in function, and also some regulation is homeostasis that may be regulated or it can be maintained from that horn. Then the pupation occurs in dense silken cocoon. Example, mulberry silkworm, Bombyx mori, and it is the important source of natural silk from insects. Then Coslidiidae, this is slug caterpillar. It is medium sized moth with stoutly built body. The body is stoutly built. The larvae resembles the slug. All of you know the slug, slugs and snails. So the snails are having a conch on its back, and the slugs, they are not having such a conch. They are just black colored and moving here and there. You might have seen during the rainy period. The larvae is thick, short, fleshy and stout. The larval head is small. Try to avoid the comments. I didn't disable it. The thoracic legs are minute, and abdominal segmentation is indistinct. Then the prolegs are absent. Poisonous urticating hairs are present on the body. The body is having poisonous hair which are attached to some poison glands. Then the pupal cocoon is hemispherical with urticating hairs. And example, castor slug caterpillar, Latoya lepida. Then the family, Crambidae. These are the grass moths. Their labial palps are extended, forewings are narrow and elongated. At rest, they are wrapped around the body. Means the forewings, they are wrapped around the body. The body is covered. The larvae bores into root, stem or crown of gramineous plants. So Chilopartilus, this is the sorghum stem borer, and it has been given properly. It bores through the crown, or you call the whorls of the plant in the gramineous family. Then family Galicidae, the forewings, they are trapezoidal. You can see in the photograph on the right hand side, just like a trapezoid. They are trapezoidal and narrower than the hind wings. The caterpillars bore into the seeds, tubers and leaves. Example, cotton pink bollworm, Pectinophora gossypiella. This is a very serious pest in our cotton crop. Then Geometridae, we know the loopers. Both pairs of wings are angular and thin, and this classification of loopers and semilopers is on the basis of presence of number of legs in polypod larvae, and also what the basic shape they attain while their locomotion. The larvae is naked and elongate. It shows protective resemblance to twigs or stems. Means their color may be for getting themselves in line or in the resemblance of the twigs or the stem. Only two pairs of prolegs are present in 6th and 10th abdominal segment. 6th and 10th abdominal segment is having proleg. Means in addition to the three thoracic true legs, here are the prolegs on the abdomen. It walks by drawing the posterior part of the body close to the thorax. Means these prolegs, proleg bearing abdominal segments will come forward and it will catch hold the leaf or the surface just at the point, near the point where the true legs on the thorax, they have caught the branch. And later on, it will hold the branch or the twig or the leaves, and then only after holding by the prolegs, it will lift up its true legs. Then it walks by drawing the posterior part of the body close to the thorax, the body forming a loop. It is also called as inchworm, measuring worm and earth measurer. Just avoid the comments. Measuring worm and earth measurer. Example, T looper, Biston suppress area. Biston suppress area, true, or such loopers, they are seen with two extra pairs of legs on the abdominal 6th and 10th segments. Then next is the family of tussock moths, the family Lamantridae. The antenna is bipectinate, legs are clothed with woolly hairs, female is provided with a tuft of anal hairs, larvae is densely hairy. You can see the larva is having too many hairs on it. And example, Castor hairy caterpillar, Euproctis fraterna. Then family Noctuidae, Noctua moths are the examples. They are medium sized, stoutly built moths. They are nocturnal, as the name suggests. They are nocturnal means they are active during the night time, and they are attracted to the light. Labial pulp is well developed. Crockets, as all of you know, they are present on the prolegs, on the larval prolegs, are all of one size. They are all of one size and arranged in a semicircle in case of Noctuidae. This is a very important family. Keep this in mind. Many of the pests of agricultural importance, they are from this Noctuidae family. Some larvae are semilopers. They have either three or four pairs of prolegs. All of you know the prolegs now. They are present on the abdomen. The larvae attacks the plants during night. The larvae of some species remain concealed beneath the surface of the ground or litter on the surface during day and feed on the plants during the night. So, as the name of the family suggests, these are the larvae which will emerge out at the night time, and they are going to feed our plants and other economic produce, and we are going to have a big loss, because whenever they will be out at the night time, we are not going there to control or manage them. And also for monitoring or catching them or killing them or destroying them, it is very, very difficult at the night time. The next, they often cut small seedlings close to the ground, and hence they are called cutworms. Example is cutworm, tobacco cutworm, and it is also called as tobacco leaf eating caterpillar, Spodoptera litura. You can see the adult, how it looks. Okay, the margins, the forewings, they are having the brown color, yellowish as well as white patches, and design at the margin. And this is the larva of this tobacco leaf eating caterpillar, or tobacco cutworm, whatever is referred, from the family Noctuidae. Very bad pest, you may say, of our agricultural crops. Then Pteropholidae, the plume moths, the fissured wings, types of wings we have seen. The fissured wings are present in the plume moths. They are small, lightly built moths. Four wings are elongate with 2 to 4 clefts of these margins, or you may say the fissures are there. Then the hind wings have 3 divisions, Hind wings have 3 divisions. Fore wings are with 2 to 4 divisions or fissures. Okay, hind wings with 3 divisions. The legs are long, slender, and armed with prominent tibial spurs. Example, Exelastis automosa. This is a Thur plume moth, that is red gram plume moth. Scientific name, Exelastis automosa. Family Pyrostridae. Proboscis is vestigial in many species. Labial pulp is snout like. The larval habit varies. The larval habit varies means it may change its habitat. Then it may live among aquatic plants and bore into the stem, or remain in silken web among spun up plant parts. Spun up plant parts means they are uniting them. Okay, they prepare webbing and they feed inside. Again, some larvae are aquatic and gill breathing. They may have the modifications for breathing whenever they are in the water. Rice stem borer. So you know that rice needs water. It is most of the time having submerged conditions for growing rice. And this is a paste of rice, Scarpophaga insertulus. Yellow stem borer is also one synonym to it. Then Saturninidae. These are the moon moths or giant silkworm moths. They are large size moths, antennae bipectinate. Transparent eye spots are present near the center of each wing. The spots are either circular or crescent shaped. The larva is stout and smooth with scoli. Cocoon is dense and firm. And this family, other than the Bombycidae family, these members of Saturninidae, they are producing silk for our consumption. We are rearing this members, the members of this Saturninidae family for our silk requirement. And the members from this Saturninidae group, they are producing the silk. That silk is called as vanya silk, because they are to be reared in the jungle only. Most of the times they can't be reared in the confined area or in any kind of a shade that we can do in case of mulberry silkworms. Example, Tussar silkworm, Anthria papia, which gives silk. And you might have come across such moths where there are prominent eye spots. And see, these eye spots, they may resemble some predator. Okay, such eyes, they may resemble some predator, and hence the natural enemies will run away, they will not attack it. Spingidae family, they are the hawk moths, the spink moths, hornworms. Spingidae family, they are large size stoutly built moths, big ones. The antennae is thick towards the middle and hooked at the tip. The proboscis is very long, because these moths, they are feeding on the nectar in the flower. And so even if the flower is having deep sited nectar, it will go there and feed inside and take away the nectar and get the nutrition. The proboscis is very long, four wings are elongated and pointed with very oblique outer margin. Four wings are elongated and pointed. They are very oblique, means they are much diagonal if you consider a square condition. Then hind wings are reduced in width, fitting into the indented margins of forewings. They are powerful flyers and they make a very strong noise when they are flying. Larvae is smooth with mid-dorsal horn. An anal horn is present on either abdominal segment. The pupation takes place in earthen cells, and in many species the proboscis is enclosed in a separate sheath. Example, the death's head hawk moth, Acherontia styx. It is a defoliar on gingelly. Gingelly means sesamum. And the markings present on the thorax of abdomen presence the adult moths resemble the Human skull means the markings on the thorax and abdomen, they are showing their resemblance to the human skull. You might have seen such a thing. This moth is not having that much marking on, just like the death's head hawk moth. In the later part or in later presentations, we will have it. Okay, then the skipper family. Earlier we had the butterfly family, then the moth family, then now the skipper families. So Hesperidae, they are the skippers. The antennae are widely separated at the base and they are dilated apically to form a gradual club. Each antenna is apically prolonged beyond the club into a hook or small recurved points. Then the wings are comparatively small. They are often held partly open at rest. Flight is erratic, means not that much in a straight way, and darting, means with very high speed. The larval head is large. There is constriction beyond the head. Larva tapers towards both extremities, means at the head side and the last abdomen segments. It tapers towards both extremities. The larvae are often concealed in host foliage. They are getting themselves hidden. Concealed means hidden in the host foliage. And example is rice skipper Pelopidas matthias. So this was all about your Lepidoptera order. We'll again revise the names of the families and the in that. So suborder Ditrysia and Monotrysia families. In butterfly families, Nymphalidae, Castor butterfly, Lycaenidae, Pomegranate fruit borer or anar caterpillar, Papilionidae, the swallowtails, example citrus butterfly, Pieridae, Dentia caterpillar, Satyridae, the rice horned caterpillars. Then in moth families, Arctidae, black hairy caterpillar, Bombycidae, the silkworm moths, that is our mulberry silkworm or silk moth. Then Coslididae, the slug caterpillar, castor slug caterpillar, or you may have the mango slug caterpillar. Then Crambidae, the grass moths, sorghum stem borer. Galechidae, cotton pink bollworm. Then Geometridae, these are the loopers, the tea looper. Limantridae, the tussock moths, castor hairy caterpillar. Then Noctuidae, the Noctua moths, tobacco leaf eating caterpillar or tobacco cutworm. Pteroporidae, the plume moths, the tour plume moth or red gram plume moth. Pyrestidae, rice stem borer. Saturnidae, the tassar silk moth. Spingidae, again hit this other one. Spingidae, hawk moth, the death's head hawk moth. And the skipper family, Hesperidae, the skippers, the rice skipper Pelopidas matthias. So this was all about our order Lepidoptera. Hope you get it understood. Thank you.